Okay, so cosmetic procedures, they're all the rage. It's the trend from the workforce right over to social media, and especially now in the new world of online working and remote working, people are trying to look their best with their best lighting and backdrops in their home studios. But it transcends ages, generations now, and certainly one of the reasons likes were probably removed from, say, Instagram. They're trying to get away from certain facets of our community and daily living because there's a lot of focus and a lot of pressures on aesthetics, some of it unfounded and some of it truly founded. But what are the trends that we're seeing? Well, for one, it's up. Procedures are up. That's no surprise as the economy's up, as appearance is more valued in this country. But these are the United States statistics from the American Society of Plastic Surgery. Let's dive into them. First, remember, if you like these videos, click like. Helps our algorithm here. It helps keep them coming. Click the bell when you subscribe, because if you click the bell, you will then be notified of all the latest, greatest videos. You can be among the first to watch them. And of course, when you subscribe, go to a playlist. If you're thinking about getting jawline, nose, acne scarring, whatever floats your boat, go to my playlist and you'll be able to find specific videos on all the things you're interested in. So of the 1.8 million surgical procedures, a lot of people might be surprised to know that a facelift is not number one. In fact, it's not in the top five. It's about 120,000 procedures done countrywide. So not that many relative to what people think when they think cosmetic surgery in many cases. Number five was the tummy tuck. Number four, eyelid surgery, and number three, the rhinoplasty, your nose surgery. And those were all basically stable year over year from 2018 to 2017. Number one and two, however, were increased in numbers year over year. And number two is liposuction. Probably no surprise, and people who get liposuction often go back and get other areas done. And number one, which many people know, they like their breasts more than their face, maybe, because a lot of people get breast augmentation surgery. So if you look at some numbers, a lot of people would think butt lift would be up there. It's not in the top five, and about one-fifth of the people that get facelifts get butt lifts. So about 25,000 people get fat grafting to the buttock area. Now, when you go to the non-surgical side, it's no surprise that these made up way more than the surgical procedures that were done. They're more easily obtainable. Sometimes, in some places, they're on every street corner. People feel that these procedures, non-surgically done, are way safer. You can be in and out, and they can tailor them over time. One thing's for sure, if people need a facelift, if they need a surgical procedure to get them where they want to be, they just simply need surgery. And it's really important for people to understand when they go into their provider for non-surgical practices or procedures, if the provider says, hey, we think that surgery would be a better option, or have you considered surgery? Minimally invasive or non-surgical is no replacement for surgical. They can delay surgery, but it's just, you're going to have unhappy people if people believe that they're going to be able to get non-surgical and get the same result. Some cases you can, and your provider will let you know for expectations, but a lot of times surgery is just necessary. Let's dive into the numbers. What do you think were the top five procedures? Let's start with number five. Number five came in at microdermabrasion. Kind of surprising to me. We did microdermabrasion now for 20 years, and there's so many different twists on it with facial scrubs, facial masks, washing, deep washing of the face with certain devices that are somewhat like microdermabrasion, and some problems microderm can have, but it still hangs in there at number five. Number four, something we've been doing for many years as well, laser hair removal, still way up there in the rankings. Number three, chemical peels. even with a lot of people doing these at home, still going into clinics and getting chemical peels, not the deep phenol peels or the fully invasive peels, but more so the rejuvenating peels that are mild to mid-depth, they make up number three. Now, number two comes in as no surprise. Number two, of course, is dermal filler, something we largely talk about on this channel, makes up a big part of it. Fillers, be it cheeks, temples, lips, of course, are probably the number one area to fill compared to nasolabial folds, which is still way up there, probably equal to lips. But there's so many places you can do fillers. There's so much marketing on fillers. There's so many different types of fillers out there now. There's a lot of awareness, and Instagram social media has really amped this up. Number one, no surprise, is neuromodulators like Botox, Dysport, and Jeuveau, and new ones to come. There's going to be many on the market. Very common procedures done, and remember my video on Botox, Dirty Little Secret. Don't get caught up in doing too much Botox, because it doesn't really rejuvenate the skin, but it works so quickly, it's easily done, it has a great price point. So in the United States, a lot of people wanna go get their Botox fixed, but don't miss your skincare. Watch that video, talks a lot more about that. Now, do you know what the number one growth age group has been for these procedures? The number one growth age group. It's similar to our demographic on this channel. A lot of people are always saying, Rajani, show older patients, show older patients. Well, the people coming into the clinic, number one growing age group, 30 to 39. This is the prejuvenation group. These are the people that want to come in and they know that doing procedures early, doing them as preventive measures, taking care of the skin, wearing sunscreen, getting professional skincare lines will reduce the need for getting facelifts, will reduce the needs for surgical or at least delay surgical procedures, and they understand them. They're not fearful of them. And that's why a lot of times people find the people that are displayed on channels like this and on Instagram are very young coming in. But keep in mind one thing. People that are coming in, or when you see them and you think, oh, I'm 50, I wanna see 50-year-olds, okay? When you look at the person, they might look 35 or 40 on the channel, they're often 50-year-olds. But they're people that have been coming into clinics and they understand it, they're willing to be on camera, and they look great for their age. Just like the stars on the red carpet that you see, they often look younger than their state age because they're getting these procedures over time. They're not celebrity skin. These people aren't coming in once every 6 months like average people, or once every year, or the average person doesn't even get these procedures. Only about 10% of the potential population who are due for these procedures actually get them. The majority are scared. There's still a stigma. But if you want celebrity skin, keep in mind they're coming in every couple weeks, certainly every month. And they have their home care. So it's valued in certain groups of people. With these procedures, you can see there's increasing numbers, more and more people are getting them done, and more people are comfortable with them. Certainly, the minimally invasive aesthetic market is growing, as we see from these statistics. What's your take on all of this? What's your take on the increasing rate of plastic surgery and minimally invasive surgery all around? Are you getting them? Are you fearful? Stay tuned here, hit the like button, subscribe to keep your skin and body in beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.